morning. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Northern Nevada, where it is our mission to grow together in love, faith, justice, and joy. We here at UUFNN are growing not just in numbers, but in our faith that by being and working together, we can bring about justice and build a compassionate community. It's a joy to see each of you this Sunday as we connect for a time of reflection and introspection. We welcome all to be a part of us regardless of racial identity, ethnic background, age, economic circumstances, educational achievement, judicial history, immigration status, sexual orientation, or gender identity. UUFNN is about compassion and support, not judgment. I'm JJ Lee, and I will serve as your worship associate this morning. We at UUFNN love having new people join us for worship, and if that's you, feel free to contact the office or our website for more information. You can also click on the link in the chat box to fill out the newcomer form and sign up for our newsletter that will keep you informed of all the activities here at UUFNN. For those meeting with us on Zoom, note that you can update your name on screen, which helps everyone know who you are. You will remain muted during the service, but you can use the chat box for comments, especially during the prayer and meditation sessions. As a courtesy, please refrain from posting announcements while folks are presenting. Folks on Zoom are invited at the end of our service into small groups for coffee hour, where we break into small groups to visit virtually face-to-face. Thanks for being with us this morning.
By now you have realized that there's something a little different about our broadcast service this morning. The worship leaders are excited to be together in our great room as we begin the learning curve of our multi-platform system in hopes of better days ahead when we can regather and be in person in the great room for our service and offer our service on Zoom as well. The invitation is ours this morning to let the music wash over us, to let the words touch our hearts in the deepest of places as we come fully present this morning to our worship. We're glad that you are here. Bob Alto will light our chalice for us this morning. As I offer to you these chalice lighting words by Christine Robinson. We gather this morning as people of faith with joys, sorrows, gifts, and needs. We light this beacon of hope, sign and symbol of our quest for truth and meaning as Unitarian Universalists in celebration of the life that we share together. Indeed, let us enter, rejoice, and come in.
Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter.
Song. Open your ears to the song. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Open your hearts, everyone. Open your hearts, everyone. Today will be a joyful day.
some change. Don't be afraid of some change. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Risa Isotos called We Hold Hope Close. In this community, we hold hope close. We don't always know what comes next, but that cannot dissuade us. We don't always know just what to do, but that will not mean that we are lost in the wilderness. We rely on the certainty beneath the foundation of our values and ethics. We are the people who return to love like a North Star and to the truth that we are greater together than we are alone. Our hope does not live in some glimmer of an indistinct future. Rather, we know the way to the world of which we dream. And by covenant and the movement forward of one right action and the next, we know that one day we will arrive at home. This is the time in our service when we have the opportunity to share our bounty with each other. It is through your generosity and dedication that we here at UUFNN are self-sufficient. By each of us stepping forward and offering what we can, we provide support for all that we do for each other and the wider community. Please share what bounty you can today by texting 73256. That's 73256. Type UUFNN in the message box and hit send. You can also mail a check to the office at 780 Del Monte Lane, Reno, 89511. Or if you want to simplify the process, you can sign up for automatic giving. Contact Carol at the office for the authorization form. The August Share the Plate recipient is the Heart Foundation. This nonprofit organization relies on contributions to provide in-home caregiver services to seniors and veterans who cannot afford it. Often families are desperate to find in-home care and government programs fall short. Seniors and veterans often fall through the cracks. Our generous donations will provide a highly trained, loving, and compassionate caregiver to be by someone's side in their greatest time of need. Funding can help caregivers provide not only health care, but help with daily activities and transportation. Please help our vulnerable neighbors in their greatest time of need. Now, let the offering begin.
Thank you.
Please join me as we bless these offerings. To the work of this fellowship, which is helping more people grow in love, faith, justice, and joy, we dedicate ourselves and these offerings.
There was a young couple who moved into a new house. And the next morning, while they were eating breakfast, the young woman looked outside and she saw that her neighbor was hanging wash on the line. And she said, "That laundry is not very clean. She doesn't know how to wash correctly. Perhaps she needs better soap powder." Her husband just sat listening and didn't say anything. In the coming days, every time her neighbor was hanging out the wash to dry on the line, the young woman made the same comments. Well, a month passed, and one morning, the woman looked outside to see nice, clean wash hanging on the line. And she said to her husband, "Look, she's finally learned how to do laundry correctly. I wonder who taught her how to do that." And the husband replied, "Well, I got up early this morning and cleaned our windows." And so it is with life. What we see often depends on our own lens or the clarity of the windows through which we look. Just going to let that sit there just for a moment. There were two men very seriously ill sharing the same hospital room. And one of the men was allowed to sit up in bed for an hour each day to receive his medical treatment. His bed was next to the room's only window. The other man had to spend all of his time flat on his back. The men would talk for hours on end about their families and their careers and their homes, their military service, where they had been on vacation. And every afternoon, when the man by the window could sit up for a little while, they would pass the time with him describing to his roommate all the things that he could see out of the window. The man in the other bed began to live for these sessions, where his world would be broadened and enlivened by the description of the activity and the color outside the window. You see, this window overlooked a beautiful park with a lake and ducks and swans played on the water. Children sailed their mottled sailboats. Young lovers held hands and walked amidst the flowers of every color of the rainbow. Grand trees grace the landscape. And a view of the city skyline could be seen in the distance. As the man described his view in such exquisite detail, the man on the other side of the room would close his eyes and just imagine the thriving and picturesque scene. One warm afternoon, the man by the window described a parade passing through the park. And although the other man couldn't hear the band, he could see the parade in his mind's eye as a detailed picture. Descriptive words provided him a picture in his mind to focus on. Well, one morning, the nurse arrived to bring water for their baths to find the lifeless body of the man by the window. He had died in his sleep peacefully during the night. She was saddened. His roommate was deeply saddened. And she called for the hospital attendants to come and take his body away. Once it seemed appropriate, the other man asked if he could be moved next to the window. The nurse was happy to make the switch, and after making sure he was comfortable, she left him alone. Slowly and painfully, he propped himself up on one elbow to take his first look at the world outside in a long, long time. He opened the blinds and he strained to slowly turn to look out the window beside his bed. And to his surprise, what he found as he looked out the window was a solid brick wall. The man called for the nurse and asked what could have compelled his deceased roommate to describe such wonderful things out the window. And the nurse responded that the man was blind and could not even see the wall. And she said, perhaps he just wanted to encourage you. It's important to ponder whether we are the person looking at the dirty wash through a dirty window, or the one washing the window, or whether we are the person describing a vivid scene to offer someone else encouragement. Perhaps that was possibilities of what can be. I don't watch that much mainstream TV, but a clip came across my feed recently of one of those talent shows, America's Got Talent or something like that. And I don't usually watch those either when they come across, but for some reason I watched this particular one. And it was a young woman who goes by the name of Nightbird. As the conversation with the judges ensues, it becomes clear that she's been dealing with cancer for a few years. And in that moment, shared that she currently has cancer in her lungs and her spine and her liver. She shared that she believes it's important that everyone knows that she is so much more than the bad things that happened to her. She then sings this deeply touching song called "It's Okay." It's an original song, and one of the lines in it says, "We're all a little lost, and it's okay." Simon Cowell and the other judges are blown away and emotional, as was I watching this. And then when they marvel after the song, she simply says this: "You can't wait till life isn't hard anymore before you decide to be happy." Those words got my attention in such a profound way. I have thought about them so many times and have tried to live by them since then. You can't wait till life isn't hard anymore before you decide to be happy. Life is life, and something is always going to be hard, right? I offer these stories to us today to remind us that we can influence our perspectives. Maybe the only thing we can control is our perspective. Things are hard. Again, we face another time of uncertainty. And so I think our task is this: to find what brings us small moments of joy and do that. Whether those joys are making phone calls to lonely folks or sending someone a surprise in the mail or binge watching TV, let those moments of joy take up space, take up energy, and let them take up space and energy where there is the oppression of smoke and surging COVID and all the uncertainty we're facing yet again. This is an important moment of joy for us in this room as we prepare and believe in better days ahead. Because as I stand here, I can see your faces in the seats and I can feel your energy. And I know that one day, as we prepare, we will all be together again. I don't know what lies ahead. There are more questions than answers in these days. There are many things that we don't get to choose, but we do get to choose what we dwell on, what takes up space within us, what consumes our energy. In the time that I was away, I spent some time in Truckee, which meant making the trek on Highway 80 there and back. And you can't drive that stretch without focusing a little bit on all of the semi tractor trailers on that highway. And if you know anything about how they drive, you know that what they try to do is when they're coming down a hill, they try to allow their momentum to pick up as much as they can so that when they're going up the next incline, the momentum can help carry them. That's our task. We fill our lives with the things that can lighten us up and bring us joy so that when things feel hard, that momentum can help carry us and we can call those things forth and have them be near. As I said, I don't know what lies ahead. I only know that we are in a déjà vu place we never wanted to be. Whether it is déjà vu or whether it is a new day entirely, we can only control our own perspectives. And I know it's hard. I know it takes energy. And it's from that place that I want to encourage us. I have a hard time getting there too sometimes. It's about our focus and our perspective. The invitation is ours to put some energy into that, the moments of joy, to find our hope. As Teresa Soto says in the reading that JJ shared, we rely on the certainty beneath, the foundation of our values and our ethics. We are the people who return to love like a North Star, and to the truth that we are greater together than we are alone. Our hope doesn't live in some glimmer of an indistinct future. Rather, we know the way to the world of which we dream. And by covenant and the movement forward of one right action and then the next. One right action and then the next. We know that one day we will arrive at home. May it be so. Blessed be.
When I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love. When I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love.
And so we take these few moments to gather our hearts, our minds, our spirits together as one in these moments of community prayer and meditation. We gather from all different places through the mystery and the miracle that is technology and Zoom. And we bring together celebrations and joys and concerns and fears and worries and hopes. Today, I would like you to know that we hold in our hearts Jennifer Cullison, who was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. She will have surgery this Tuesday, the 10th, and welcome supportive messages. Chris Hyland's mother in Santa Rosa is preparing to make her final passage. And so we hold Chris and his family in our love. We gather in our hearts today all those who are facing impacts of the fires and smoke, all of those who deal with ongoing health issues, all of those who are experiencing repercussions of COVID. And we hold in our hearts all of those who are feeling lonely and sad and depressed, who are dealing with grief in their lives. And we remind each other once again that no one is alone. In all things, we hold them together. You're invited in these moments to record your prayers in the chat box so that we can share them together. We gather all of our joys and all of our concerns, and we hold them together in the heart of love. And we offer our gesture one to another, one hand on the heart, our palm, and our energy extended outward as a reminder that we are connected one to another in this community. I see you, I hear you. We see and hear one another. Blessed be, and amen. I want to thank you so much for joining us for today's service. We're so glad to have had this time together. As we look toward coming back together more fully in person, I do want to highlight over the last year and a half, we have had a small and mighty dedicated tech team that has helped with our service. And as we begin to look at coming back together, we're going to need to expand this team. So a way that you can help facilitate our coming back together is to consider stepping up and being part of that team. There is training, and we will help you. We work together as a team, but we do need more people in order to make that happen. So you can reach out to me, and I will put you in touch with Philip Moore, who is the chief guru of that team, and we will proceed forward hopefully in the coming weeks. There is a blood drive happening this Saturday in our parking lot at UUFNN. It will be a mobile van Saturday the 14th, and you can make a reservation by going to the link that is in the e-announce. So we hope that you'll participate in that. That is something that many of us can do in these days, and something that Sue and I have been doing throughout the pandemic to be of service. There is in the e-announce an announcement about the climate emergency and the way that you can reach out to our representatives and ask them as they consider the infrastructure budget to include the carbon offsets for the climate crisis. This is an important step and an important movement. So we'll ask your attention to that. And that's only through the middle of this week, that opportunity. So if you could do that in the next few days so that our voices are heard, that will be important. If you know of anyone who needs support, please contact the office so that we can connect in the ways that everyone needs. And if you're new to us online today, please do click the link in the chat box so that we can get to know you a little bit and provide you with the information that you will need to get to know us. You're invited to stay online in small group conversations for coffee hour at the close of our service after the postlude. And I'm going to invite you as we participate in our closing song to take this song as one of those moments of joy that will help bless you and carry you through this week. May it be so.
Hello, UU fan. I'm gonna sing a song with you called Shine On Me. It's an amazing spiritual that anybody can sing. And in these days, when the things that we're dealing with, the feeling separate and all of that, and things seem so hard, this is one of those songs that you just throw your head back, put it in your medicine kit. All you have to do is ask. And here's how it goes. Shine on me, oh, shine on me. Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me, oh, shine on me. Yes, shine on me. Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me. Lift me up, oh, lift me up. Let the light from the lighthouse lift me up, oh, lift me up. Yes, lift me up. Let the light from the lighthouse lift me up. Oh, oh. Yes, hold me close. Let the light from the lighthouse hold me close. Yes, hold me close. So hold me close. Let the light from the lighthouse, please hold me close. Oh, shine on me,
shine on me.
Yes, shine on me.
Let the light from the lighthouse shine on me.
Oh, shine. Yes, shine on me.
Let the light from the lighthouse shine
is just ask. The light is always there. Always. Always.
Beloveds, would you receive the blessing? In this coming week, may the light of the lighthouse shine on you, and may you be lifted up, finding those moments of joy despite all evidence to the contrary. And in these ways, may we be carried through as we remain connected one to another. Blessed be. Amen and namaste.